Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and as uncultured as I typically feel today, my rube-like shame will be exacerbated as I sit next to Vancouver resident, designer, and winner of Project Runway Season 7, Mr. Seth Aaron. That's when Outlook Portland begins right now on Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Fashion police, fashion victim, fashionably late, after a fashion, fashion of an age, fashioning a look, and of course, fashionista. The language and perspective of the fashion world are everywhere, so pervasive and omnipresent that they can at times seem almost invisible. You do, after all, live in a world designed almost entirely by other people. You may never know their names or their faces, but they are behind nearly every facet of everything you own. The color, the texture, the size, the shape, what Steve Jobs might call the distinctive look and feel of your life. Fashion and design are what make the world you know the world you know. Joining us today is a man who understands quite a bit about all of this. His designs can be found at myriad locations and events, including 2010's Portland Fashion Week. He's also the winner of Project Runway's 7th season. And calls Vancouver, Washington, his home. To my immediate right, Mr. Seth Aaron. Hello, sir. How are you today?
Hi, Rick. Thanks for having me.
When did you first become aware of fashion design? What was the first time you remember looking at something and being aware that someone created it to look a specific way?
I was about 2. And both my parents and family members confirmed that the department store's clothes is what I was interested in. That's just what I loved. I mean, I had my trucks, I had my machine gun, you know, all the little boy stuff, but I had this extra fascination for clothes and style. And everything, even at that age, like, had to be put together, I guess, from a 2-year-old's perspective, the right way. When I was like 8, 9, I started altering clothes that I would have because, you know, the idea of tough skins, I don't know if you remember those.
I have many traumatic memories.
Yeah,
of
your
tough
knees
skins.
Wear out before the tough skins do. So those were popular when I was that age, and I wasn't so hot on those.
You were not so enamored of the Sears Roebuck look.
I learned how to iron clothes when I was about 8, because I asked my mother to teach me, because everything had to be pressed. I couldn't handle it. I mean, even at that age, everything. Every event, there's an appropriate attire for that event. You know, if you're going outside to ride your dirt bike, obviously it doesn't really matter. But if you're going out to the movies, if you're going out to grandma's, even at that age, I felt that there was an appropriate attire to wear to it.
Was there a moment of revelation where you said, I think I can do this and I can do it as well or better professionally? Do you remember the moment when you said, this is what I'm going to pursue?
As far as design work, it was always, I've been a stylist, fashion stylist for print and catalog for almost 12 years now. When I got that break, I went into that, and about 5 years into it, I mean, it was always a dream, like, oh, I'd love to have this, I'd love to do that, but how do you get there? You know, this pays the bill, I really loved doing the styling as well. And then constantly, you know, photographers or modelers, they say, well, why don't you have your own clothes? You know, you really should translate this. And, you know, one day I did. And my wife actually got me my first sewing machine for Christmas about 5 years ago, 6 years ago now. And she said, you know, I'm tired of hearing about it. Just do it. And that's what I did. And I knew I could get where I wanted to be in a short amount of time.
We're talking with Mr. Seth Aaron. Stay right there. We will return to Outlook Portland in mere moments. Go nowhere. You're watching Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. And in the world of fashion, there are sometimes serious choices to be made. Is it a Green Lantern shirt day, or is it a Yellow Lantern shirt day? Classic Starfleet shirt? Cisco Starfleet shirt? Gem of Amara, or a little golden parasol? Fortunately, there is one place of such wondrous variety and bounty that such choices and scenarios are all equally viable. That place, of course, is Things from Another World. You can find them at their 4 Portland locations, as well as online at tfaw.com. They are the marquee sponsor here at Outlook Portland. And again, they can be found online at tfaw.com or throughout Portland at any one of their four physical locations. Comics, graphic novels, collectibles, toys, games, clothing, and more, perfect for the nerd or nerd-like in your life or the life of those around you. They are the most fantastic thing, period, that has ever existed on planet Earth. And their patronage of this fine television program is itself enough to earn your loyalty. Find out more about them by going to TFAW.com. That is TFAW.com or Things from Another World, their physical locations throughout Portland. Four of them, TFAW.com. Things from Another World. Whatever you're into, they have just the thing for your collection.